Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel. Continuing the video series guiding the use of the MetaTrader 4 platform on IC Markets. In this video, I will guide you on how to install and manage indicators and trading robots on MT4. With this management method, you can quickly and conveniently install indicators and trading robots on different product tabs. Furthermore, with this installation method, you will also have a beautiful and easy-to-view display, which helps you better determine market trends.
Welcome to the IB Support Channel. This information channel guides you about the IC Markets platform. If you are new to IC Markets, please subscribe to the channel to receive the most useful information.
To install indicators and trading robots on the MetaTrader 4 platform, please go to the Navigator section. You can click this icon or press Ctrl plus N. You can also go to the View section and select Navigator. When you do that, the Navigator section will appear on the left side like this. You will see the following sections. The first section is Account. This section helps us manage trading accounts. The second section is Indicators. And the third section is Expert Advisors, which means trading robots. And this last section is Scripts. This section is almost no longer needed. If we want to add indicators to the screen here, we will use the indicators in this section. These are the indicators available on the MetaTrader 4 trading platform of IC Markets when we first install it. In the next video, I will guide you on how to add external indicators to this trading platform. For now, we will just use the available ones. Indicators here are divided into many different groups, and it also depends on which type of indicator you want to use that you will drag it onto the screen. For example, the trend indicator group. Here you can find Bollinger bands, Ichimoku, or moving average, the MA line. These are indicators that follow the price. If you want to add an indicator to the screen, you will left-click on that indicator and drag and drop it onto the screen. Then, the next step is to set the indicator's parameters. The indicator's parameters will vary depending on the indicator, and different settings will appear here. For Bollinger bands, we will need to choose period or deviation. This parameter is usually left as default. The levels section for Bollinger bands does not need to be set. For the visualization section, we will set the display time frame. We leave all time frames selected, which means we will display Bollinger bands on all time frames. However, if we want to display it on a few specific time frames, we will uncheck all time frames and select the corresponding time frame. Here, I will still leave all time frames selected. After setting the Bollinger parameters, I will click OK. If you want to modify this indicator, you can move your mouse over that indicator, then double-click on the indicator, and the table will appear, allowing you to adjust the indicator's parameters. For example, you can adjust the color of the indicator or adjust the lines of that indicator. Other indicators will be added similarly. Here, I'm adding the moving average line. I will set the moving average line to 20, and I will make this line yellow. Then, I will click OK, and it will perfectly align with the middle line of the Bollinger bands. These two will overlap. However, if we want to use the moving average line with a larger period, we will increase the period value here. Then, I will set it to blue. For example, then I click OK, and you can see it's displayed here. In addition to indicators that follow the price like this, there are also indicators that display at the bottom of the screen. For example, stochastic. You will also modify the information of that stochastic, modify its color and level, etc. Then, we will click OK to drag it onto the screen, and when it's displayed on the screen like this, it will narrow our chart area. We can move the mouse cursor to the horizontal line near the bottom. When two opposite arrows appear like this, you will click on it and drag down to reduce the space below. Now, there are quite a few different indicators like this. If you want to modify a specific indicator, clicking on it can be confusing. Right, so, you will right-click on the screen and select Indicator List. Then, the table of indicators that we have installed on the screen will appear. If you want to modify an indicator, you will double-click on that indicator, For example, I will change this to 10.5.5, for example, then I will change the color of this to yellow. For example, this line, I will make it bolder. For example, so, you can see that I have modified this indicator. If I want to delete an indicator, I will click on that indicator. Then, I will click delete. For trading robots, we will go to the expert advises section. Regarding trading robots, MT4 does not provide many by default. It only has these two robots as examples. However, if we want to use a specific trading robot, we will need to program it or buy it and add it to the MT4 platform to run it. So, assuming you already have your preferred robot, if you want to use it, you will also click on this trading robot and drag it onto the product chart that you are interested in and want to trade on. You drag it out, then, you will modify the parameters of that trading robot. In this case, the robot provided here only has some basic information, a few pieces of information like this. So, once we have a clear understanding of a robot's information, we can then modify and adjust these parameters according to our preferences and suitability for the product we are trading. After adding it like this, we should remember to check allow live trading, and also click here, only then can it function well on our trading platform. And we click OK. So, you can see that in the top right corner, the robot is already displayed here. And if you look closely, you will see that this robot has a face next to it. And this face is showing a sad face like this, meaning the robot is not yet active. If you want it to be active, you will need to click this button, the auto trading button. When you click auto trading, the red button will turn into a green button, which is the running button. And at that time, the sad face here will have turned into a smiling face. And that's when the robot starts working. And it is also important to note that for this robot to work, the trading platform we are currently running must be launched. Otherwise, if we close MT4, this robot will also stop working. It only works when MT4 is running. Therefore, if you want to use the robot 24/24, you will need to rent a VPS to run it. To manage this trading robot, you can also right-click on the screen and select Expert Advisors. You can select properties to go back to the robot settings. If you no longer want to keep this robot, you can also right-click on the screen, select Expert Advisors, then select Remove, and it will remove the robot. And also note that the robot we install will only run and operate on the product chart it is placed on. Other products like these will not be affected. That means it will not trade other product pairs besides the product on which we have placed the robot on the chart. All the things we set on the screen here only appear in one tab. If you want these indicators to appear in other tabs and you want to switch to other tabs without spending a lot of effort setting them up, we will do the following. We will utilize the template feature. Go to the template section above. Pay attention to this icon. Then, click Save Template. You will save the template with the indicators you have already set up here. For example, I will save it as IC Trading 2. Then I click Save. Now, if I want to add these indicators to the chart of this product, I will select the template section. Then I will select IC Trading 2. So, very quickly, the indicators set up in this product tab have been transferred to the next product tab. Very fast, right? And this way, we can display many product tabs like this. However, if we open a new product, the product's chart will still be in a different format, not what we want to display here. So, when we save this template, we note that we save template, but we will not name it anything random. Instead, we will name it default. You click default, or you can name it default. Here, I had previously named a template like this. So it appears here. Normally, if you are new to installing it, it will not display default. You will name your file exactly like this. All the letters like this. Then you click Save. Now, when you open new product tabs, it will always display the indicators just like the ones we have set up here. So, that's how we manage indicators and trading robots very quickly. And so, I have finished guiding you through the operations to set up and manage indicators and trading robots on the MT4 platform. If you find the video useful, Please give it a like and click the subscribe button and the bell icon next to it to receive the latest videos when the channel is active. Especially, next, I will upload a video to the channel guiding you on how to add external indicators and trading robots to this platform, helping them run smoothly and support you better in determining market trends.